Hello friends, I hope everyone is fine. I have already made 3 videos on nucleophilic substitution reactions. So I thought we need a clarity about nucleophiles and leaving groups. Obviously nucleophiles are having a lone pair of electrons, and leaving group, the group which leaves, outgoing group that also goes out with an negative charge, right? So we need to know that the conditions which are specially required that can make a better nucleophile and a better leaving group, right? So let's start. Now this is the general equation I have taken here, the carbonyl group. Here this X is a leaving group and Y is a nucleophile, right? We should know that, we need to understand that this Y can be attached at the place of X if Y is a better incoming nucleophile, right? And X is a better leaving group. So this is what I have written here. Then only this reaction can proceed properly. We'll get this as an product, right? So in a leaving group, X should be a priority in a leaving group, preferable, and Y is a less preferable as a leaving group, but as a nucleophile it's better as compared to X. Here electrostatic attractions will be there between carbonyl group and nucleophile. How we can say, here oxygen is the electronegative group which pulls the electron from the carbon. So carbon becomes more electrophilic, which requires an electron from the nucleophile, right? Now we will see, as I said you, that a nucleophile is the one which comes with a negative charge and gives the electron to the electronegative, what we say, electrophile. Right, nucleophile we say is we'll see some conditions, that is nucleophile is inversely proportional to electronegativity. If you see in a periodic table from left to right, electronegativity increases, right? So what we say, we can say that nucleophilicity will decrease, right? If you see here, example I have taken of acidity. Here HI is a more acidic in nature as compared to HBr and HCl and HF. As I said, your weak base is a good nucleophile. We will get here H plus I minus, H plus Br minus, H plus Cl minus, H plus F minus. So now here nucleophile R in order will be I minus, Br minus, Cl minus, F minus. We can say that electronegativity is inversely proportional to nucleophile is inversely proportional to electronegativity, right? Here we can compare that from top to bottom electronegativity decreases, right? So nucleophilicity will increase. Here we can say, and we have taken this point also, that weak base is a good nucleophile. So I minus is a weak base, it's a good acid with HI, right? So I minus is a good nucleophile. Nucleophile order in periodic table we will see, that will be, has to go from left to right, nucleophilicity decreases, right? Because electronegativity increases, and top to bottom increases because electronegativity decreases. Here we will say after nitrogen phosphorus will come, right? So NH3, here N is more electronegative as compared to this, so it is more nucleophilic as compared to NH3. Here if we take H2S, here S is a bulky group as sulfur as compared to oxygen, and oxygen is a more electronegative group as compared to sulfur, right? So it is a more nucleophilic in nature as compared to H2O. If we take here, the similar concept we will apply here also, and similar concept we will apply here also, right? Now next we will see, is directly proportional to basicity. If we see, basicity is basicity is inversely proportional to electronegativity. We can say like that also, that here carbon is least electronegative as compared to nitrogen, then nitrogen is least electronegative as compared to oxygen, then fluorine is more electronegative group in the periodic table. So here CH3 can give electron easily as compared to nitrogen, and this can give as compared to oxygen, and this always tries not to give because it's a more electronegative group. It always thinks to take the electron. It's a person like who always takes things from others and not able to give. Now steric hindrance increases nucleophilicity, right? Here if there is a steric hindrance, this will decrease its nucleophilicity. This is a better nucleophile. Now, steric hindrance increases if steric hindrance increases, nucleophilicity decreases, as we seen in the previous slide. Here, this is best because it is just stuck with these three groups, so it can give electrons easily as compared to this. Now, as electron density increases, it means the negative charge on this as compared here, there are lone pairs, nucleophilicity will increase. Here, OH is a better nucleophile as compared to water. NH2- is a better nucleophile as compared to ammonia, that is NH3 amine group. RO- is better as compared to ROH. RS- is better as compared to RSH. Now we can say this is an example we have taken. This is a this question has came in NET exam also. That we'll take. They'll give this three, this four groups to you, and they will say you write a decreasing order of nucleophilicity. Nucleophilicity is what we give electron. It provides electron to the electrophiles easily. So here you can see CH3O-, that is RO-, can give better as compared to what we say peroxide. Phenoxide group, and then this CH3CO2, it have equivalent structures, right? And then NO3, because it's a most electronegative group. You can take this order like this. Now we will have hard nucleophiles and soft nucleophiles, two types of nucleophiles. Hard nucleophiles are the nucleophiles which are small in size and think that not to provide electrons easily. Here it attacks on the carbonyl group, because these are hard nucleophile, not easily provide electrons, but if we pushes them with the electrostatic attraction, there is electrophile, that this is carbonyl group, and nucleophile can easily provide an electron to it. Soft nucleophiles are the large nucleophiles, attack at saturated carbon. This already we have done this in the nucleophilic substitution reaction. It's saturated carbons. Here will be homolumo attractions, and RS-, I-, I- is a better nucleophile, that is soft nucleophile, than alkenes, which have double bond and aromatic rings. Now, leaving groups means the group which leaves and will be that place will be replaced by another group, that is nucleophile, right? Stable, and now we will see which can be good leaving group. Stable anion means the group which leaves and is a stable anion is a better leaving group. And then lower pKa, better leaving group. pKa is inversely proportional to acidity, right? HI is greater acid, HBr is less than this, HCl and HF. This is the acidic order. Higher acidity, lower will be pKa, right? Means I- is having lower pKa. Now you can see this is the same order as we have seen in nucleophile in the previous slides. I- is a better leaving group as well as a better nucleophile. Now this is you keep this as a star mark, that if there is a good nucleophile, that will be bad leaving group, and bad nucleophile good leaving group. This is a general thing we see. Now leaving group order is chlorine. Already we have seen in the last video that stable anion is a better leaving group, right? Here it's a stable anion, the electronegative group. It is equivalent structures, and then RO-, then amine. Here R is a never leaving group. Okay. Now this is the question we have on the based of this. This is carbonyl. This is RMgX. Here Mg, that is magnesium, will be having positive charge. It will be negative charge. It will give an electron, and this bond will get pushed up, and it will be having negative charge on it. Then this will be pushed here, and OR is a better leaving group, right? So it will be replaced by methyl. And we got this product. Now we'll see this. Here there is methyl, here there is methyl. Here we had already OR- that can become a better leaving group and will go, because it can make a stable anion. That's the reason it is not stable and makes a stable product. Now here also RMgX we have taken, instead of methyl we have taken here ethyl. No matter if you take methyl, you can take. Now it will attack, and this bond will pushed up, and the same we will get like this. But here what happens is that won't be stable, but after giving this water, there will be a water in the reaction, so it will provide H that will be attached here, and this will be the product. Thank you. I hope you have understood the concept, and If you have any doubt or else if you are liking the video, please give thumbs up, share and subscribe the channel. Stay home, stay safe.